The first Dead Space always felt like an underrated game, which eventually led its way to becoming a sleeper hit. It was essentially a great game that offered a bit of change of pace in the formula. Headshots didn't make things easier. It was all about strategic dismemberment. Enemies weren't chasing after you wave after wave, but meticulously paced to provide fear and tense. Sure, it's been done before, but it was done very well. My only complaint was the horror elements were not that frightening. But in the first few seconds of Dead Space 2, my heart was pounding. I found myself surrounded by necromorphs, mutilated corpses of the deceased turned into horrific monsters, and running away while being in a straitjacket. Run, run, that's all the hell I could think of as I quickly maneuvered past the sharp blades of a monster. I felt the necessity of speed and quickness, but Isaac has none of that. His slight, slow turns and heavy strides only built up my panic even more. As I found myself escaping the wave of monsters, I still didn't feel safe. My arms were strapped tightly around my chest. It was this brilliant set of pacing that really started off the game great. You felt vulnerable and helpless. Isaac did not have his trusty engineering suit and was completely dumped into a state of confusion as to what is happening. I mean, the whole situation of finding yourself in a psychiatric ward overrun with necromorphs makes it feel like you're in a demented nightmare, and Dead Space 2 tells a hauntingly emotional nightmare. The most drastic change you'll notice from the very beginning is that Isaac is no longer a silent protagonist. He has dialogue. He has a story that develops so well over time that you'll want to see it through to understand what is going on.
Just cut me out of this straitjacket. No one's getting out of here alive. Don't do it.
As he struggles with his strange visions, he seeks his way through the space station city known as the Sprawl to find out answers of why his demons have returned. It's something I really didn't expect to make much of an impact, but it only suits to create a more developed story than the original. Visceral Games did an exceptional job of capturing Isaac's character and expanding the original game's story. Visually, Dead Space 2 is a wonderful improvement from the monotonous, dark corridors of the USG Ishimura. Oh, it's still dreary and dark alright, but the sprawl is much more diverse with shopping districts, a Unitology church with some unique architecture, and many more. The lighting engine is what makes this actually superb and extremely immersive, yet it's the sound department that takes the cake here. On more than one occasion, I literally jumped at a sound of a necromorph creeping past me or the hissing of steam pipes. You literally owe it to yourself to make sure you played this game on a good audio system. There isn't much has changed in terms of the way you play Dead Space. Shooting off limbs with Isaac's trusty plasma cutter is just as satisfying as the original. And the sprawl offers a whole slew of interesting new weapons to dismember your opponents, each with their own set of alternate firing modes. Isaac also can upgrade his suit on many different occasions as he progresses through the game, each with their own benefits. There are a whole set of old and new necromorphs that appear throughout the game, ranging from your classic two-blade creatures to acidic spitters that slowly seem to peel you away. Probably the most interesting improvement is how you traverse through zero gravity. With your trusty boosters on your feet, you can now float freely and travel in full 360-degree motion, which sets up some interesting sequences throughout the game. The game is linear at heart, but by no way a bad thing, as it creates a great sense of pace and trepidation. My personal suggestion, if you would like to have a true horror experience, make sure to play on survivalist mode. I've had plenty of occasions where I've had to constantly conserve ammo. I literally carried an average of 13 plasma cutter ammos and 20 line racks throughout my playtime. Yet as much as the game provides a scary experience, it tends to die off as you progress further through the game. I still have those unexpected moments where I get caught off guard, but it seems to occur less and less as you make your way through the sprawl. This may be due to the fact that you feel much more powerful as you progress through the game, but in no way deters you from playing. Isaac's story is enough to make sure you make it to the finish. Dead Space 2 is a step above its prequel. It makes great improvement in terms of set pieces, sound design, story, and gameplay. Although the fear may dwindle as you make your way to the end, it's still worth every penny to see it through. If you've been itching to butcher more necromorphs and delve deep into the mind of Isaac Clarke, here's your perfect opportunity. Game Blurb's verdict? Buy this game.